mean that a lot of juggling, as you were saying, Gail.
Yeah, I'm sure that if you talk to the folks in this room, they can understand very, very readily what you just said. I mean, the fact is that the producer is the last person to get paid in this paradigm. It's the first person to get blamed.
To get yelled at.
Yeah, and so it's a tough road. I hate to sound negative, because it's the kind of passion that we have that keep us going. But it is a tough road when you're an independent person and out in the marketplace. The writer is going to get paid, and other people will get paid long before your check is written. And then everybody likes to take a little bits away from you as you go. It's like, well, okay, in order to keep it going. And we do that. And it is it's difficult to sustain ourselves. And I think there's a lot of people in this room who I can see they're nodding their heads. It's really true. It's always been that way, I think. There's nothing quite new about that. But as the game changes, we have to be the most flexible people, because we're the ones that have to say, okay, is this something that's for Netflix, for example? If it isn't for Netflix, I think I can make it for Amazon. So there is that world out there where the major studios are very, very, very specific in their needs. And you can even get that wrong, as Lucy just said. But you have to be really able to move around in order for your stuff to get made and to sustain yourself.
And we were talking too the other day about the level of packaging in television. It's like on the steroids. I mean, people are walking in.
This is what I blame on the movie business coming into television. No, I get asked about this, and I think it's really interesting. It used to be, and for those of you who work in television, you'll understand this, television made the stars. So you could put an entire cast of unknowns on television, and if the show was successful, many of the folks became a star. Look at ER, it's a great example of that, and that's quite a while ago. But it's still true to a certain extent. But now, in the competitive marketplace that we're in, the standard is much different. And movie folks coming into the television area have taken the idea of packaging that is so... that's the way you put things together in the movie area. In TV, you used to be able to just come in with a pitch. Remember those days? That is so almost over.
You have to have a star, a director.
They like a script and a whole package at many of these places. And I mean, I remember years ago when we cast Kiefer Sutherland in 24, and Kiefer was great and amazing. I remember Peter Chernin saying to me, "Why would you cast Kiefer Sutherland? You could have cast somebody who wasn't a star, or didn't have a prominent name, and you know, it would have been half the price." Well, it was just an example, I think, at the time, of the philosophy of TV making its own stars. Today, I think it would be much more difficult to pull that off. Yeah.